that nobody knows about. I want you to thank God right now that I come to play games with the instrument. And give thanks to him and praise his name. Somebody shout, there's power in his name.
The reason, I told myself,
Ren, I'm going to do it this summer. I'm taking my picture off and I'm going to rewrap it, but the next wrap won't have no picture on it because I was trying to mark it because we had billboards up and I began to get convicted because it ain't about James.
That's right.
Okay. When you walk into the church, you don't see my name or my big head face anywhere in the lobby. When you walk back here, even on my office, there's no name even on my office door. The only reason why my name is on my desk is somebody bought that for me. I wouldn't have bought it. They bought it for me. I don't want to be mean and they come to my office and I don't have it in there. So there's nowhere in the building, look at me, that you can read and see my name. No, because the truth of the matter is, it's not about my name. It's about his name. Okay. So when you come into the household of God, you're not coming here praising God for the person who's sitting beside you. You're not even praising God for your boss that you don't really want to see tomorrow anyway. No, the name that you're praising is the name that's above every name. That the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. I need somebody right now to shout Jesus. It's all about you. I don't come to praise God for you. I came to bless. Look at me. There's something that you're only going to get if you praise God. See, the real test of relationship is, do you love me enough to still show me that you love me, even though you don't feel the love I'm giving you? Because the matter is, let's be honest, sometimes you don't feel like God loves you. Matter of fact, you don't feel like God is even in your life because you feel so alone and so abandoned. You begin to question, God, do you see me struggling with this stuff? And so he said to you, I want you to still praise me and show appreciation to me despite what you're going through in your life. Here we go. When you come to church, the atmosphere ought to be so thick with worship. Because not because Elder Taylor's praying, not because we're waiting for praise and worship to start, but when I walk in here, I immediately start thinking about what he brought me out of. I immediately start thinking, we have to get out of this churchy mindset where my praise is only contingent upon musicians and music. You know when I really praise God, I really worship God? When I'm driving a van all by myself. I'm going to tell you this week, and the reason why I'm preaching this week, and I ain't going to lie, I said, they're going to think I'm crazy. I pulled the van over on 440. And just put it in park and just went into worship. And have no radio on, because you have no idea what people go through. You have no idea what struggles people deal with. And every time you think about what God has brought you out of, you're going to say, God, I thank you. My life could have went another way. I could have been dead a long time ago. I could have lost everything. I could have been abandoned and left.